Okay, so let's dig in. We have this high-stakes scenario. The government is running a deficit. They need cash.
Right.
But the private market, well, it isn't buying their bonds. So the central bank steps in and essentially just buys them up.
It really does sound like the perfect solution, doesn't it? Almost like a cheat code for government spending.
It does. But today, we're going to unpack why that's not quite right, looking at it through the lens of the neutrality of money.
And specifically, we're looking at what happens when the US government tries this while the economy is already at full employment.
And that's the key, isn't it? That full employment detail changes everything.
Oh, completely. We're not trying to kickstart a stalled economy. The engine is already, redlining.
So if we follow the chain of events here, the first thing that happens is pretty straightforward. The central bank buys the bonds,
Right.
and that floods the system with new money.
And, well, basic supply and demand kicks in. When money is suddenly everywhere, the price to borrow it, the interest rate, it has to drop.
Right. And usually cheap money is a good thing. Businesses see those low rates and they think, okay, now's the time to expand.
Exactly. Aggregate demand starts to surge because capital is, for all intents and purposes, on sale.
But this is where we run smack into that wall we mentioned earlier.
The full employment wall.
Yeah. In a regular economy with some slack, all that new demand would mean more production, more jobs. But here, there's no more to give.
I mean, you can't just produce more goods out of thin air. Every factory is already running at capacity.
It's kind of like a sold-out concert, right?
That's a great way to put it. The venue is full.
So if you suddenly print another 1,000 tickets,
You don't get a bigger venue. You don't magically add more seats.
All you do is make the existing tickets more valuable on the street. You create scalpers.
You create scalping, not capacity. And that scalping in our economic model, that's inflation.
Right. Since the economy can't physically make more stuff to meet the demand, the only thing that can give is the price.
Everything just gets more expensive.
And that's the trigger for the big correction in the ISLM framework. So initially, you see the LM curve shift to the right.
Yeah, because of all the new money. It looks like the economy is expanding.
But then reality sets in. The purchasing power of that money.
We're talking about real money balances. So, M over P, the money supply relative to the price level.
And since prices are rising just as fast as the new money is being pumped in.
The actual value, the real purchasing power of the economy, hasn't changed at all. The increase in the M is just canceled out by the increase in the P.
So that rising price level actually forces the LM curve to shift back.
All the way back to the left, right where it started.
It's like a boomerang effect.
Yeah.
You push it out with cash,
And inflation just pushes it right back.
and we land at the exact same equilibrium point we started from.
Which brings us right to the core idea of neutrality. The whole operation was neutral when it comes to the real stuff.
So total output, GDP, no change.
Same as before.
Right.
Real investment is the same. Employment is the same.
The only, and I mean the only, lasting change is the price tag on everything.
Precisely. That's the danger that the source material points to. You go through this entire risky financial
And
maneuver.
all you're left with is inflation. You haven't created a single ounce of real wealth.
It just separates that nominal illusion from the real economy.
Which leaves us with a pretty tough final thought for everyone to chew on. If the model is so clear, if the consensus is that this path leads only to inflation and not to growth,
Yeah.
why is there always so much political pressure to rely on the central bank to cover deficits in tough
Is
times?
that illusion of free money just that seductive?
Something to think about.